Major conferences, we've got the tournament this week. This is one of those times of year in conference tournaments where you have teams that either are playing well or teams that are struggling. Who is struggling going into conference tournament week?
Yeah, Seton Hall is struggling maybe because of the teams they played. They lost to Villanova, they lost to Creighton, they didn't defend a three. Their DNA is to get stops, to make it up, to be hard to score against, to pressure the ball, to protect the front of the rim. Miles Powell knocking down threes. They got away from their DNA. They weren't as good defensively. So what happens? Villanova Creighton knocked down threes. They got beaten back to back. I think they survived this. I think Seton Hall is still Final Four good. They've got a guy who can take over a game like Kemba and obviously Miles Powell. Then this Baylor team, they concern me because Mark Vidal's been hurt a little bit. And they're built on the defensive end. They got to rebound the basketball. They got to defend. They got to create offense out of their defense because they're so reliant on their backcourt. And when the backcourt not shooting the ball well, especially Mitchell, they struggle. Baylor is a major concern for me, no doubt about it. And then Kentucky. I like Kentucky. They won the SEC by multiple games, but all of a sudden, Ashton Hagans steps away from the basketball team. When you have one of your leaders step away in March, if your locker room is not locked down and together and everyone pulling in the same direction, that is a concern. Kentucky, talented enough, but not great depth. Ashton Hagans stepping away even just for that weekend is a concern because you're only as good as your locker room this time of the year.
You mentioned Hagans stepped away from Saturday's game due to the personal reasons, but Kentucky head coach John Calipari says they need him at 100% for the postseason. All right, bubbles. Big time for the bubble teams heading into conference tournament. Who are we looking at that's on the bubble that needs a big run in their conference tournament?
Yeah, there's a couple teams that I think need to take a step forward in bubble time. And the first is NC State. NC State, you're talking about a team that their seniors got to take over. They've been on the bubble now for 24 straight months. Last year, they didn't get in. This year, they have some good wins. But Markel Johnson, C.J. Bryce, and Funderburk, those upperclassmen have got to take over. They need to beat one of the top four in the league, whether it's Virginia, Duke, Florida State, or Louisville. And then UCLA. UCLA's had an incredible run at the end of the season. And they're led by Tiger Campbell, his ability to get in the lane, and Chris Smith, a big shot maker. UCLA needs to finish the deal. They can't afford a bad loss. When you're on the bubble, two things have to happen. One, you can't afford a bad loss. Two, when you get an opportunity to beat that team that is ahead of you, who is in the field, you need to beat them. If not, you know what Saturday becomes? Sleepless. Believe me, I know.
Bruins, one of the last four. And you can't have a team that was on the bubble or someone come from nowhere and win their conference tournament.
Utah
then you're
State.
Done. Yeah.
Boom,
they'll take a team out.
East
NC
Tennessee,
State, gone.
All of America is rooting for East Tennessee. If you're on the bubble, East Tennessee today is playing Wofford. Everyone's rooting for East Tennessee.
And NC State, one of the last four in that, according to our bracketologist, Joe Lenardi. Speaking of Virginia, if they score 52 or 54 points,
did you get a chance to see their national championship?
I did. Look at they're big. They look good.
Very big.
Like Seth, he always looks good. Thank you, Coach.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports and analysis, download the ESPN app and live streaming sports and premium content. Subscribe to ESPN+.